Dear colleagues, title of our presentation, Role of Hydrogen in Operational Degradation of Pipeline Steel. The presentation scope. Introduction, general regularities of degradation of long-term operated pipeline steels, assessment of the steel condition based on hydrogen behavior studies, argumentation of hydrogen influence on operational degradation of steels, and concluding remarks. Introduction. Ukraine is one of the most important transit countries to the countries of the European Union. It has an extended network of gas transmission pipelines built more than 30 years ago. Therefore, the problem of aging in their integrity is very important. One of the factors which defines evacuability of transit pipelines is a loss of the mechanical properties during long-term service. It means steel degradation. Failure analysis of gas pipelines shows that environment-assisted cracking is often responsible for a loss of pipe integrity. On this slide, you can see stress corrosion cracking from external pipe surface. However, it does mean yet that the process on internal surface does not play any role in a loss of pipe integrity. Our previous electrochemical studies of corrosion process on pipe steel in the environment which simulates condensed water showed that the process is accompanied by evolution of hydrogen, so pipe wall can be hydrogenating from internal surface during operation. So, steel degradation will be caused not only due to working stresses, but simultaneous effect of stresses and hydrogen under operation. It should be also noted that this process can be possible on long distance of pipeline in spite of external surface located in certain places of a disbanding isolated coating. So, in this talk, we would like to concentrate on the role of hydrogen in operational degradation of pipeline steel. General regularities of degradation of long-term operated pipeline steels. The main peculiarity of operational steel degradation consists in a decrease of plasticity and brittle fracture resistance, like impact strength and fracture toughness. On this slide, you can see figure with relative change these parameters during long-term service and fracture toughness defined by J integral is more sensitive to degradation than impact strength. But sensitivity of impact strength can be increased if used part of this parameter, namely energy for crack propagation, it means crack growth resistance. Regarding the characteristics of plasticity, the special attention should be paid for elongation. Problem is in the following. Long-term service causes development of microdamage or degraded steel is sensitive to cracking during specimen tension, and then elongation will summarize really plastic deformation and multi-cracks opening. It will at least diminish elongation decrease or even increase it. On this slide, you can see as operated 30 years steel is characterized the less level of fracture toughness, but the highest level of elongation. As confirmation, you can see some examples revealing damage accumulation by mechanical loading. On left, the fracture surface of exploited steel after impact test, and on right, surface of specimen after tension test. Based on this, two stages of pipeline steel degradation are distinguished. Deformation agent and in bulk steel dissipated the microdamage. Hydrogenation intensifies the damaging process due to hydrogen-induced microcracking of steel and in this way, facilitates its operational degradation. In service, damage intensified by hydrogen can cause untypical mechanical behavior of metal. A decrease in strength and hardness is accompanied by reducing brittle fracture resistance, an increase in elongation, simultaneously with a decrease in reduction in area. Assessment of the steel condition based on hydrogen behavior studies. Investigation of hydrogen behavior in steel by hydrogen extraction and permeation methods provide valuable information for assessment of in service dissipated damage degree. So, the hydrogen permeation method, Devanathan and Stachurski, is used taking into account that hydrogen in a metal is located mainly in defects, which consider it as hydrogen traps. Thus, using this method, one can determine intrinsic, latest, and apparent hydrogen diffusion coefficient, and also their relation as a measure of the trapping efficiency. On this slide, you can see that the exploited steel is distinguished by high relation of diffusion coefficients, it means high level of microdamaging. Using hydrogen extraction method, it was obtained that in the case of steels in the initial state, most of hydrogen was desorbed at a low extraction temperature, 200 degrees, whereas the operated steel is characterized by high temperature of desorption, indicating hydrogen trapping of high energy. And as you can see on this slide, a decrease of brittle fracture resistance is in a good agreement with hydrogen concentration in metal. Higher hydrogen concentration corresponds with lower level of impact strength. The electrochemical method of hydrogen permeation was used for the estimation of metal susceptibility to hydrogen-induced cracking. For this purpose, the cathodic current density applied to the ingress surface of the metal membrane was increased step by step. Each time, this led to the increment of anodic current density in the egress cell. The regularity maintained until damaging became under combined action of hydrogen and residual stresses induced by intensive hydrogen charging. Then, a sharp decline appeared on the ionization curve on the egress light of the membrane that indicates the trapping of hydrogen with newly formed defects, that is, the development of hydrogen-induced damaging. Thus, the cathodic current density, which is corresponding to a defect occurrence, is considered as the critical. It allows determining the metal susceptibility to hydrogen-induced cracking. As you can see, metal in the initial state, in comparison with the exploited steel, is characterized by higher level of the critical cathodic current. It means more resistance to hydrogen cracking. Argumentation of hydrogen influence on operational degradation of steel. A clear evidence of a destructive role of hydrogen in degradation of long-term operated objects derives from a comparison of the properties of different metal parts of the same installation that had different hydrogenation conditions during operation. As an example, you can consider oil storage tank where some parts contacted with residual water and water vapor, another one with oil only, and parts which contacted with aggressive in hydrogenation sense environment are characterized by a lower level of impact strength. Another example, the top and bottom section of the pipe operated of the oil pipeline for 30 years. A residual water was collected at the bottom of the pipe and formed favorable conditions for corrosion and subsequent hydrogenation of the lower section of the pipe. As a result, steel properties of the pipe bottom were essentially worse comparing to its top sections. Special attention is paid to the role of hydrogen in damaging rolled steels with texture. The mechanism of microdamaging of textured steels is suggested to be the accumulation of hydrogen at the interface elongated non-metallic inclusion matrix, creating high pressure in defects with the following micro-delamination along the rolling direction. Such cases of macro-delamination happen mainly in above-ground pipeline sections, where temperature changes are especially noticeable and result in moisture condensation at the inner pipe wall. Similar to the previous example, moisture inside the pipe became a reason for corrosion and hydrogenation, facilitating steel degradation. As a result, insurance damage becomes oriented in the direction of rolling. Then the direction of specimen cutting becomes especially important for a correct evaluation of steel properties. Preliminary presented scheme about two stages of operational degradation was developed based on testing longitudinal specimens cut in the rolling direction, as commonly. Using this type specimen type in Sharpe testing, the fracture plane intersects rolling direction and hence preferable direction of delamination. This requires additional energy that could result even in an increase in impact toughness, as illustrated at stage 2b, when level of impact stress can be increased. This leads also to anisotropy of characteristic of brittle fracture resistance of rolled steels, which becomes more pronounced with operation time. And here you can read some concluding remarks.